Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Hope Kuching Sunday Online Service. Let us come and praise our God together. He is our Father, our Master, and our friend. Amen.
Yeah. 血为我而流，每个心烦为我承受，恩典如海，四面环绕，十万羞愧时，你仍拥抱着。
耶稣，没有任何的事情能够使我们与你的爱隔绝。主，我们祷告说，上帝，让我们继续的在你的爱里面成长，让我们继续在你的同在里面更加的成长。感谢你如此的爱我们，哈利路亚，奉耶稣的名我们祷告， Amen。
Hello everyone, good morning and welcome to our online service.
Hello, 大家好，大家早上好。我欢迎你出席我们今天早上的线上崇拜。
We are so glad you can join us.
我们很高兴你可以共享圣局。
And I pray that the word of God today will speak to you and bring great blessing to your life.
我祷告说，神今天的话语可以直接的跟你说话，为你的生命带来极大的祝福。
That you can experience the wholesome life or the abundant life that is in Jesus Christ.
直到你可以在基督里面经历到神所指的那一种丰盛和健康的生命。
You know, we only have one life to live, so I think it's important for us to think, what kind of life do we really want to live?
我们大家都只能够活一次，所以是很重要的一个关键，我们要去想说，到底我们的生命要怎么活。
And when you think about life, You realize that life is full of ups and downs.
当我们去思考生命这个课题的时候，我们不难理解说，我们的生命就充满着起起落落。
Even in your own life, I'm sure you have experienced all kinds of challenges and situations that can affect you strongly.
在你自己的生命当中，我相信说，你也面对过许多的问题，许多的挑战，会大大影响你的问题和挑战。
And the question for us today is there a way to live a life that is contented and is not depending on whatever is going on around us?
那今天的问题是，我们是否能够活出一个有满足的生命，不依靠我们所发生的事呢？
You see, the world is telling us that that whatever they sell, they promise it will give you satisfaction or contentment.
你看，世界上的人他会告诉我们说，他所卖给我们的产品或者他卖给我们的东西是可以为我们带来满足的。
Is it true that things that we buy or accumulate in our life can really bring us that ultimate satisfaction?
那我们生命当中我们所购买的这一些产品和东西是否真的能够为我们带来真正的满足呢？
You know, today a lot of people are very concerned about how they look.
那今天有许多的人非常在意他的外貌。
They are willing to, because they don't feel contented about themselves, so they may use beauty products or they may wear expensive clothing in order to make themselves feel satisfied.
那因着他对他们自己的外表非常的不满意，他就会用许多的保养品、许多的化妆品，穿起许昂贵的衣服来装饰他自己，让他自己得到那份满足。
But do you know that in God's eyes, you are more valuable than what you wear?
但是你晓得吗？在神的眼光当中，你比你所穿着的更为珍贵。
A lot of young people may think that it is the expensive branded things that make them valuable.
许多年轻人都会认为说，他们外在的这些穿着昂贵的名牌会让他们更加的有身份。
But actually, your true value is because God loves you.
但是你真正的价值应该源自于神的爱。
You don't have to use all these things to make yourself feel valuable or satisfied.
你不需要用这一些东西使到你自己得着满足，或者使到自己有价值。
And there are many other things.
还有很多其他的东西。
What about you?
那你呢？
Are there areas in your life where you are not satisfied?
是否在你的生命当中有一些领域是你非常不满意的？
How do you improve yourself in that situation?
你如何在这样的情况当中使自己有所进步？
So I have good news for us, and Paul has something to say to us.
那今天我要告诉你一个好消息，就是保罗有东西，有功课要教我们。
We're going to read from Philippians chapter 4 right now.
我们将会从腓立比书第四章一起来看神的话语。
From verse 10 to verse 20.
从第十节到第二十节。
And Paul says, I greatly rejoice in the Lord that at last you renewed your concern for me. Indeed, you were concerned, but you had no opportunity to show it.I'm not saying this because I'm in need, for I have learned to be content whatever the circumstances.
我靠主大大的喜乐，因为你们思念我的心如今又发生。你们向来就思念我，只是没得机会。我并不是因缺乏说这话，我无论在什么境况都可以知足，这是我已经学会了。
Verse 12, I know what it is to be in need, and I know what it is to have plenty.I have learned the secret of being content in any and every situation, whether well-fed or hungry, whether living in plenty or in want. I can do all this through Him who gives me strength.
我知道怎样处卑贱，也知道怎样处丰富，或饱足，或饥饿，或有余，或缺乏，随时随在，我都得了秘诀。我靠着那加给我力量的，凡事都能做。
Yet it was good of you to share in my troubles. Moreover, as you Philippians know, in the early days of your acquaintance with the gospel, when I set out from Macedonia, not one church shared with me in the matter of giving and receiving except you only.
然而你们和我同受患难原是美事。腓立比人啊，你们也知道我 传福音离了马其顿的时候，论到受受的事，除了你们以外，并没有别的教会会攻击我。
For even when I was in Thessalonica, you sent me aid more than once when I was in need. Not that I desire your gifts. What I desire is that more will be credited to your account.
就是我在帖撒罗尼迦，你们也一次两次的打发人攻击我的需要。我并不求什么馈送，所求的是你们的果子渐渐增多，归在你们的账上。
I have received full payment and have more than enough. I am amply supplied. Now that I have received from Epaphroditus the gifts you sent, they are a fragrant offering, an acceptable sacrifice, pleasing to God. And my God will meet all your needs according to the riches of his glory in Christ Jesus. To our God and Father be glory forever and ever. Amen.
但我样样都有，并且有余，我已经充足。但我从巴以巴弗提受你们的馈送，当作极美的香气，为神所收纳、所喜悦的祭物。我的神必照着他荣耀的丰富，在基督耶稣里，使你们一切所需的都充足。愿荣耀归给我们的父神，直到永永远远。Amen.
Let us pray.
让我们来祷告。
Lord Jesus, help us today to understand that we can have complete contentment.
主耶稣，你帮助我们来理解说，我们的生命可以拥有完全的满足。
And that is not found in the things of the world.
这一切都不能够从世上的事情当中寻找。
It's not found in people.
也不能从人当中找到。
It's not found in possessions.
更加不能在我们的产物当中找到。
Help us to learn from Paul today.
帮助我们向保罗学习。
In Jesus' name.
奉耶稣的名。
Amen.
Amen.
Friends, today I want to talk about complete contentment.
那朋友们，今天我们将会谈论的是完全的满足。
In other words, I want to encourage you to be satisfied in Jesus Christ.
换句话说，就是你要在神里面找到你的满足。
You know, if we depend on things around us to give us satisfaction, it will come to a place where you find that it doesn't have any meaning anymore.
如果我们依靠我们身旁的事情或者事物来得到满足，那么你会来到一个阶段，你会觉得一切都是虚无的。
The things of this world are not meant to give us ultimate satisfaction.
因为世上的事物本来就不是，它的存在意义并不是让我们得到那终极的满足。
So what is complete contentment?
而这个完全真正的满足是什么呢？
And how can we have this complete contentment?
而我们又如何得到这份完全的满足？
So, I want to talk about three things.
那今天我们会谈论三个关键。
And the first is to know the nature of contentment.
那首先我们就要理解到这一个完全满足的本质。
And that nature is called independence.
而这个本质就是它是独立的，无关的。
In other words, to have complete contentment, we must realize it is independent of circumstances.
就换句话说，如果我们要知道什么是完全的满足的话，我们必须理解到它其实无关我们的情况。
And Paul says in verse 11, I have learned to be content whatever the circumstances.
保罗在第十一节讲到说，我无论在什么情况都可以知足。
In other words, Paul has been set free.From being a slave to whatever is going on.
换句话说，保罗他已经得着自由，他不再是他所发生事情的这个奴隶。
He has found a satisfaction that doesn't depend on situations.
他的满足不源自于他的情况。
What about your life today?
那你今天的生命又是怎样的？
Is it depending on things around us? If things go well, then we are satisfied. If things are not going well, then we are dissatisfied.
我们是否还是依靠我们身旁的事物？当一切是顺风顺水的时候，我们觉得非常的满足。但是当一切都不顺我们的心意的时候，我们就开始觉得很糟糕。
Now think about Paul for a while.
我们来思考保罗。
He wrote the letter to the Philippians in a prison.
当他写书信给腓立比的时候，他其实在监狱里头。
And although he was in prison, the letter to the Philippians is full of joy.
那纵使他在监狱里头，但是这一封信却充满着喜乐。
It's like, wow, being in prison doesn't destroy Paul's spirit or attitude.
你看，在这个 在监狱里头的时候，他并没有打败保罗的心灵。
It's almost like he's in prison, but his spirit is not in prison.
他其实就好像他人在狱中，但是心灵却不被囚禁。
Years ago, when I was sick in the hospital, I cannot move, but my heart was so free in God. I can worship and pray. I can rest. It was like wonderful.
很多年前，当我在医院的时候，我的身体有状况，我不能够动，但是我心灵里面却是非常的自由。我可以安息在神的面前，我可以敬拜神、祷告神。
Because I learned what Paul says, whatever the circumstance.
因为我向保罗学习，无论什么境况
，it doesn't affect the real contentment when we are in Christ.
它都不会影响我们在基督里面所得着的满足。
So Paul says, whether he's empty or plenty, he is contented.
保罗说，不管他是缺乏的，不管他是富足的，他都非常的满意。
When Paul was doing ministry, and people welcome him, he have a roof over his head, he has food to eat and a bed to sleep in, he was contented.
当他去做这个福音的工作的时候，有人来欢迎他，让他有地方、有庇护所、有床好睡、有东西吃，他非常的满足。
But Paul was equally contented when he has to sleep under the night sky beneath a tree and feeling hungry.
但是保罗的这个满足还是同样的，在同样的一个等级，当他需要在夜空下面睡觉，然后没有东西吃的时候。
What are we trying to say here?
那我们现在想要表达的是。
What I'm trying to say is that our contentment must not be dependent on whatever happens around us.
就是我们的满足其实不可以源自于我们身旁所发生的人事物。
Because if it depends on our circumstances, then we will become like a yo-yo Christian.
倘若他是依靠我们身旁的景况的话，那我们就好像悠悠一般的基督徒。
If you've seen the toy, the yo-yo, you know, it goes up and down, goes up and down.
就好像这个玩具悠悠一样，你会看到它会起起伏伏。
That means we're not stable.
就好像我们很不稳定。
And unless we learn to be stable, in God, we will forever be affected by what's going on.
除非我们可以在神里面稳定的话，不然我们是很容易，我们都很容易被影响。
What about you today?
那你今天呢？
Are you living a life as a follower of Jesus where you have learned not to be your satisfaction is not dependent on situations?
那你今天作为神的这个追随者的话，你是否已经学习到这个功课，不要被你的情况影响你呢？
Are you still living underneath the storm, you know, where the rain and the thunder and lightning, or are you like the eagle that have flown above the storm where it's all peaceful and calm?
你是活在这个狂风暴雨之下，还是你已经像老鹰一样翱翔在暴风之上了？
You know, God wants us to learn to be set free from depending on circumstances.
你知道吗？神他其实要我们学习得着自由，从我们的情况当中得自由。
So then it the question is how do we actually do that?
那问题是我们要如何做到呢？
So let me talk about the second thing, and that's the reality of complete contentment, and that is really about our position in Christ.
那么就看到我们的第二个关键，我们来看的就是在基督里面的地位，这是很重要的真相。
Contentment is really about a living relationship with Jesus.
因为这个满足其实是源自于跟神之间活泼的关系。
And when your relationship with Jesus is so strong and so alive, whatever is happening around you doesn't really affect you.
如果你跟耶稣之间的关系是很刚强、很活泼的话，不管发生什么事情都不会为你带来影响。
Actually, that's what Jesus wants you and I to have.
那也是耶稣基督其实要我们做到的。
And so we read this from verse 10.
我们可以从第十节里面看见。
Paul says, I rejoice greatly in the Lord.
保罗说，我靠主大大的喜乐。
You know, when you read the book of Philippians, you find that a lot of times, whatever Paul is writing, he always refers back to the Lord Jesus,
当你去看腓立比这本书的话，你会发现保罗这个人，他不管发生什么事情，他很常都会回去看靠主或者在主。
That means that Paul was rooted in Christ.
他意表着说保罗这个人扎根于基督。
He had this living relationship with Jesus, and he was Christ-centered all the time.
就意表着说他是扎根于在神那里，他是活泼的，他跟神有一个活泼的关系。
Another way to put it is that he finds his satisfaction in this life in Jesus Christ.
就换句话说，他在他这一辈子的生命当中，他是从基督耶稣那里找到满足。
He is not finding satisfaction in life in things or people around him.
他并不是靠着他旁边的人事物来得到他这辈子的满足。
But of course, he rejoices when he sees Christians show love and care. Like for him, you know, they renew their concern, so he rejoices.
当然他很喜乐，当他看见更多的信徒可以展现他们的爱心，展现给他，展现给不同的人。
But the center of Paul's heart is Jesus Christ.
但是保罗生命里面的中心是耶稣基督。
And so you read, Paul even says things like, for me to live is Christ, to die is gain.
所以你会看见保罗会这么说，我活着就是为基督，我死了也有益处。
What does that mean?
它意表着什么呢？
What Paul is saying is that, you know, every moment that I'm alive, whether in prison or preaching, or traveling around for the gospel, you know, it's all about Jesus.
你看，他其实所要表达的就是我生命当中的每一个时刻，不管我在监狱当中，我在传道，我在路上等等，每一个所做的事情，每一件事都因着耶稣基督。
And when he said to die is gain, what does that mean?
他说我死了就有益处，那又意表着什么呢？
See, he's already walking and living with Jesus in this world.And he says, to die is gain.
他很努力地在这个世上跟耶稣一起同工去做神的使命，那么他会觉得说他死了也会得益处。
Why did he say that?
为什么他会这么说？
He said that because he knew that if he died, he's not going to hell. He's going to be with Jesus.
因为他很清楚地晓得说他死了之后他不会下地狱，他会跟耶稣在一起。
He's going to a far better place.
他去一个更好的地方。
It also means that he has finished running his race.
就意表着说他已经完成了他的赛程。
He has completed his mission on earth.
他完成了他在世界上的使命。
But you also read in the book of Philippians where Paul says, I am torn between the two decisions.
但是你可以在腓立比书里面看见说保罗说他已经被这两件事情为难了。
On one hand, he wants to go with, to be with Jesus now.
那一边的他很想要跟耶稣在一起。
He wants to go into the eternal kingdom and see Jesus face to face.
他想要去到永恒的国度面对面的见耶稣。
But on the other hand, he sees that the church still needs him.
但是同时在另一边厢的时候他也看见教会还需要他。
He knew that he still have things to do for Jesus on earth.
他知道说在世上他还有一些事情要为着耶稣而完成的。
And so he writes that, convinced of this, I think it's better for me to stay on.
所以他这么写说，就因着他这样 他的考量之后，他觉得他活在世上是更好的。
You see, when you are positioned in Christ, every decision you make is always referring back to Jesus Christ.
你看，当你把你的自己的定位定在耶稣基督里头的时候，你所做的每一个决定都会以耶稣为依据。
In fact, Paul also said that everything that I have, I count as loss because now I have found Jesus.
那保罗也曾经这么说过，我已经将万事当作有损的，因为我已经认识了我的主耶稣基督。
That, you know, there's nothing that can compare with getting to know Jesus more and more.
意表着说没有任何的事情可以跟耶稣认识耶稣来做比较。
And that's why Paul says even things like, I want to know Jesus Christ in his suffering.
他更加表达说他想要去懂得耶稣所经历过的苦楚。
What is Paul talking about?
那保罗所要表达的究竟是什么？
Paul is saying that no matter what situation, because he's with Jesus,He can always get to know Jesus more in that situation.
他的意思就是，不管他在什么样的一个情况，因着他在耶稣基督里头，他可以透过那个情况去更加认识耶稣基督。
So every opportunity he has is always about knowing Jesus more.
每一个机会他所抓紧的都是看到说他可以更加的认识耶稣基督。
Paul is not just knowing Jesus more when he has freedom, and staying in somebody's house.
保罗他不会因着他因有自由能够住在别人的家的时候他认识耶稣基督。
But when he was in prison, he wants to know Jesus Christ more in the midst of being a prisoner.
那当他入狱的时候，作为一个囚犯，他也想要更加的去认识耶稣基督。
In other words, he experienced the presence of Jesus.
换句话说，其实他在经历着耶稣的同在。
My dear brothers and sisters, it's so important for you to experience the presence of Jesus with you in your everyday life.
我亲爱的朋友们，你知道吗？是很重要的一个关键，你需要在日常生活当中有耶稣基督的同在。
To know that Jesus is with you, whatever situation you are going through.
你要晓得说，不管你在面临怎样的一个情况，耶稣都与你共同度过。
Many years ago, when I was in sick and in the hospital.
很多年前，当我在医院的时候，我还在生病。
Sometime in the middle of the night, the nurse would switch on the light and then come and check my blood pressure.
那半夜的时候就会有护士来检查我的血压。
Sometimes they will poke needle to take my blood sample.
有时候他们也会抽血。
And you know, every time they poke a needle into me, I think about Jesus dying on the cross. That Jesus, your pain is so much more than my pain. Thank you, Lord, for dying for me.
每一次当这根护士用针筒来插进我的血管里面取血的时候，我都能够联想到耶稣在十字架上的工价。我能够想到说，神啊，很感谢你可以为我在十字架上所做的牺牲。
So somehow that tiny needle helped me to have a powerful worship with Jesus Christ.
那么小小的针筒就帮助我有一个很美好的敬拜。
It made me love Jesus more.
它让我更加的爱耶稣基督。
You see, when you are positioned in Christ, you're always referring whatever you go through to Jesus.
你看，当你可以把你自己定位于耶稣基督的时候，那么不管你在经历什么东西，你都可以把它看为耶稣基督的依据。
And so today, brothers and sisters and friends, no matter what you're going through, make sure that you are in Christ and Christ is in you and with you.
那么弟兄姐妹朋友们，不管你在经历一些什么事情，你要确定的是你基督活在你里面，你活在基督里面，基督与你在一起。
Because when you have that, that becomes even more precious than what you're going through.
当你有这一切的时候，其实它会更加珍贵，比你所经历的一切。
When you are in Christ, a cup of water tastes just as wonderful as a can of Coca-Cola.
当你在基督里面的时候 你理解到神的同在一杯白开水可以跟可乐相提并论
It has nothing to do with the food or the drink that we have
因为它其实本来就不关乎于食物本身
It's about who we have in us
其实关乎于我们内在所拥有的
And when you have Jesus in you You have the Savior The one who saves you from your sins The one who loves you and gave his life for you
当你拥有耶稣基督的时候，意表就说你有一个救主，一个爱你的救主，愿意付上生命代价来救你的救主。
And because you are in this position in Christ, you have the help of the Holy Spirit, our counselor. You have the power of the Holy Spirit to witness for Jesus. You can do signs and wonders through the power of the Holy Spirit.
当你把你自己定位在耶稣基督，也因着你有耶稣基督在你里面，那么你拥有了圣灵所赐给你的能力，你可以来有能力靠着圣灵去为神做见证。
And when you're in this position in Jesus, you have God as your heavenly Father.
当你可以把你定位在耶稣基督的时候，那么你同时也可以拥有我们的天上的神作为我们的父。
Because of Jesus Christ and what He did for you and me on the cross.Now we are the children of the Father.
因着耶稣基督在十字架上的工价，今天我们可以称我们的神为我们的父。
So Paul's satisfaction is not based on the circumstances. Paul's satisfaction was based on his relationship in God.
那么保罗他的满足不来自于他的身边的人事物，他的满足是源自于神。
So maybe your marriage is not doing that great.
也许你的婚姻并不是那么的美满。
But don't depend on your husband or wife to be the one who give you the ultimate satisfaction.
那 但是你不需要依靠你的伴侣来赐给你这一份完全的满足。
The ultimate satisfaction can only be filled by God.
因为这一份完全的满足只有神可以让我们得着。
So when you are in Christ,
所以当你在基督里头
and you are satisfied in your relationship with Jesus Christ,
你跟耶稣基督的关系得到一份满足
it can actually improve your marriage life.
它其实可以让你的婚姻生活更加的美满。
But don't expect your marriage life to bring you the ultimate satisfaction.
但是你不能够依靠婚姻为你带来完全的满足。
Until we are satisfied with Jesus alone.
除非我们从耶稣基督那里得到满足。
And when we are satisfied with Jesus, you know, we bring a different quality to our relationship with people.
当我们在耶稣里面找到这一份完全的满足的时候，我们会带来我们的关系上、素质上的改变。
So let's look at Paul again.
我们再一次来看保罗的生命。
Paul says, "I rejoice greatly in the Lord."
保罗说：“我靠主大大喜乐。
”And because he was in the position in Christ, he was content in Christ for his daily needs of ministry.
因着他在耶稣基督里面 的地位，因着他在耶稣里基督里面的满足，那么他在他的这一个服事上面，他也可以得到满足。
And because Christ is with him, you know, he was willing to accept whatever Jesus Christ gives to him.
那么因着耶稣基督是跟他同在的，他愿意去接纳基督所给他、所赐他的一切。
So in the course of his ministry, if he is accepted to preach in a synagogue, hallelujah.
那么在他的这个侍奉的道路当中，如果他可以在会堂当中宣讲神的话语的话，那么他说哈利路亚。
But if he was arrested and thrown into prison, he still said, Hallelujah, I accept whatever you allow me to go through, Jesus.
纵使他锒铛入狱的时候，他也可以呼喊哈利路亚，说我感谢神，我感谢神，我接纳神所赐给我的一切。
You see, that changes everything.
你看这个思想可以改变一切。
And because of that, Paul was able to endure any problem he faced as he seeks to be faithful to fulfill God's calling.
因着这如此，他就可以忍受任何他所遇到的问题，当他忠心的去完成他的使命，去宣讲福音。
For those of us who are serving the Lord Jesus today,
对于那一些还在服侍神的弟兄姐妹们
，Our satisfaction should not be in the number of people that's coming to your life group.
我们的满足不应该来自于我们小组组员有多少人
，or our satisfaction should not be based on how well we did this or did that.
我们的满足不应该源自于我们做得有多好。
Of course, we should desire more people to come to Christ.
那当然，我们应该要渴望有更多的人来到神的面前。
Of course, we should have an excellent spirit to do our best in everything.
那当然，我们也需要有一个卓越的灵来去做每一样的服事。
But I think it's far more important that even if you do a lousy job, you know, something messed up and it was not as good, but in Christ, you are satisfied with Jesus.
但是在更加重要的是，纵使你做得不好，你觉得很糟糕的话，但是在基督里面，你可以找到那份满足。
Find that contentment that nothing can destroy.
你要找到一份完全没有任何事情可以打败的满足。
And then you can keep on serving the Lord with power and with impact.
那么你就可以持续的在神的道路当中带着影响力的去服事。
So We talk about the reality of this complete contentment. Now let me talk about how we can actually have this complete contentment.
那刚才我们讲到这一个完全满足的真相，那么现在我们来看我们要如何得到这份完全的满足。
Paul was able to have this contentment because it is through Jesus Christ.
那么保罗他能够拥有这份完全的满足，因着他来透过耶稣基督。
Paul says in verse 13, I can do all this through him who gives me strength.
保罗在第四章十三节里面说到，我靠着那加给我力量的，凡事都能做。
You can also say that, Paul is saying, I can endure all the ups and downs and be okay because I have Jesus Christ who gives me strength.
换句话说，保罗他其实要表达就是，我可以忍受所有的起起落落，可以忍受所有的境况，因着耶稣基督给我力量。
In other words, he knows that Jesus is the one who provides him the strength to go on.
也意表着说他理解说神是那个赐他力量去前进的。
And Jesus also wants to be that provider for you and me today.
那今天耶稣基督也要我们为我们提供这一份力量。
No matter what hardship or struggle or problem you're going through today, don't give up on Jesus.
不管你在经历什么样的难处、什么样的挑战、什么样的逆境，不要放弃耶稣基督。
Maybe your situation is difficult.
也许你的情况是非常的困难。
But you are in Christ, you have a living relationship with Jesus today.
但是你因着你在耶稣里面是有地位的，你跟神是有一份活泼的关系。
And Jesus is just a prayer away.
那么耶稣跟你之间的距离就只是一个祷告。
You can even talk to the Lord Jesus right now about your situation.
你甚至可以跟神来说你自己的情况，就现在就跟神诉说。
Ask him for help.
求神帮助。
You know, Paul asked Jesus for help many, many, many times.
你晓得吗？保罗他很多很多次的向神求帮助。
When you read the book of Acts, you will see that Paul had gone through all kinds of trials, challenges, disappointments in fulfilling the mission of preaching the gospel.
如果你去读《使徒行传》的话，那么你会发现保罗他在这个宣讲神的话语这条道路上，他遇到了许许多多的试炼挑战。遇到了许多灰心失望的事情。
But he never gave up.
但是他从不言弃。
In fact, in those situations when it was the lowest point in his life, he found that Jesus was there.
就是在这些他生命当中的低谷当中，他看见耶稣在那里。
He found that in the darkest place, Jesus was the light.
他发现说在他生命当中最黑暗的角落，耶稣就是那份光亮。
And so he knew that Jesus is the one.
他晓得耶稣就是那一位。
Who gives him strength.
为他带来力量。
One time, Paul says, I have this thorn in my flesh.
曾经保罗这么说到，他在他生命当中有一个刺。
It could be a health problem that he had.
他可能是他身体上面的一些问题。
And this health problem is affecting him in being able to serve Jesus, effectively.
而这个身体上的问题有可能是能够影响他，使他没有那么有效率的去服侍。
It might be a hindrance to him.
对他而言是一个障碍。
And so he prayed to Jesus, Lord, please take away this thorn in my flesh.
他跟耶稣这么祷告说，主啊，如果可行的话，求你挪走这一个刺。
He prayed three times.
他祷告了三次。
And the Lord said, No, I'm not going to take this thorn away.
那么主也说我不会拿走这个刺。
He said, My grace is sufficient for you.
因为他说我的恩典足够你使用。
You know, I believe our God is a God of healing.
我相信说我们的神是医治的神。
And if you have some thorn in your flesh, you should pray, God, heal me, help me.
如果你生命当中你的肉体上有任何的刺、任何的病痛的话，你应该跟神求医治。
And many people have experienced healings and miraculous.Hand of God in their health situation.
许多人在这个身体健康的问题当中都经历到神的医治，神的神迹启示。
But maybe you are one of the few where, like Paul, Jesus says, "My grace is sufficient for you."
那但你也有可能是那个极少数的，就是神要对你说，我的恩典够你使用。
Just like what Paul went through.
就好像保罗所经历的。
And Paul says that he experienced what it reallyHow it make a difference in his life.
你看保罗他说他经历到说他如何为他生命带来不同。
Paul knew that Jesus still provided.
他知道说耶稣仍然供应。
Jesus provided the best for him.
耶稣他供应最好的给保罗。
And Paul was confident that Jesus is Jehovah Jireh, the God who is our provider.
那么保罗他也非常有确信说耶稣就是耶和华以勒我们的供应者。
And he can provide for whatever needs in our life.
他可以提供我们生命当中所有的需求。
And in fact, Paul was so confident, he says to the Philippian church and to you and me today in verse 19, And my God will meet all your needs according to the riches of his glory in Christ Jesus.
那保罗他非常的有确信，以至于他下腓立比的信徒这么说，也对今天的你和我这么说：我的神必照着他荣耀的丰富，在基督耶稣里，使你们一切所需的都充足。
My dear brothers, Jesus Christ is our provider.
弟兄姐妹朋友们，耶稣基督就是我们的供应者。
And we can trust him.
我们可以信靠他。
And so, you know, until we find contentment in Jesus Christ alone, we will always be dissatisfied with people, with situations, or even with ourselves.
除非我们单单在基督里面找到那份满足，不然我们总是会因着人、因着情况、因着我们自己本身而感受到很多的失望和不满足。
Contentment in Christ set us free from the devil's traps.
这一份来自于基督的满足可以使我们从魔鬼的圈套当中逃离。
Contentment in Christ changes how we view whatever situation we are in.
那么在基督里面这一份满足也会改变我们所在的时候我们如何去看待我们的情况。
Go and look, pray and ask God what is the root of your discontentment.
可以去祷告问神说你生命当中不满足的根源是什么。
And very likely you're going to find your insecurities.
那你很可能找到的根源就是缺乏安全感。
And if you look inside your insecurity, you might discover that you have a wrong identity about yourself.
如果你去真正探讨为什么缺乏安全感的话，你去深入的去探讨这件事情，你可能会发现说，你对你自己身份的认知是错误的。
If that happens, you need to come back to that position in Jesus Christ.
如果这个是你的话，那么你需要回到你真正耶稣基督里面的身份。
Know that He is the Lord, our Savior.
我们要晓得说，我们的神是我们的救主。
And know that when we have Jesus Christ, He is more than enough.
我们要晓得说，当我们拥有耶稣基督的时候，我们有他也就足够了。
So how do we practically experience this?
那我们要如何很实际的去经历呢？
You can read the whole book of Philippians.
你可以去读腓立比书整个。
But I want to suggest four things.
但是我要提醒你们有四个关键。
First is take Paul's life as an example.
那首先就是我们以保罗的生命为榜样。
Read Philippians and see how his life is an example for us today.
你可以去看腓立比书，我们可以从腓立比书去看说如何要活出我们的生命。
Secondly is rejoice in your relationship with Jesus Christ.
那么第二点就是因着你和耶稣基督的关系而欢喜。
Even if you don't find joy around you, make sure that you find joy in your relationship with Jesus Christ.
纵使你可能在我们的身旁的人事物找不到喜乐的话，那么你要确保说你可以因着你跟神之间的关系而欢欣快乐。
Thirdly is, you know, we all have worries and concerns, and worries can usually make us dissatisfied.And discontented.
那么我们每一个人都有自己的忧愁，我们都有自己的愁烦，这些的忧愁和愁烦都可能会造成我们不满足。
So bring your worries to God.
把这些的劳苦重担，这些的忧愁都带到神的面前。
And the fourth suggestion is occupy your mind positively.
那么第四个提议就是你要用积极的方式去填满你的思绪。
Don't waste our time and energy thinking on the wrong things.
不要把你的时间精力浪费在去思考一些负面的情绪。
Come to Jesus.
来到神的跟前。
You know, there's this pastor, his name is John Piper, and he said this statement that really blessed me all these years.
有一个牧师，他叫 John Piper, 他曾经说过这么一句话，他很祝福我的生命。
He said, God is most glorified when I am most satisfied in him.
他说过，当我能够在神里面找到最大的满足的时候，神就得到了最大的荣耀。
And today I find that my satisfaction is not based on situations around me.
那今天我也发现说，我的满足不源自于我身旁的人事物。
Of course, there are times when I also become insecure.
当然，有一些时候我也会缺乏安全感。
And compare things.
我开始会做比较。
Those are the times when I.Quickly go back to Jesus Christ.
也在这个时候我会很快地回到神的跟前。
Because he is the one who will never ever change.
因为他就是那一个永不改变的神。
I want to invite you today.
那今天我要邀请大家。
To know that our God will provide.
我们要晓得说我们的神他会供应。
He is Jehovah Jireh.
他是耶和华以勒。
And the greatest provision that God has given us is when Jesus Christ gave of his body to die for our sins.
而耶稣为我们做的最大的供应就是把耶稣放在十架上为我们的罪死去。
And because of that,
也因着如此，
our sins have been forgiven.
我们的罪得着赦免。
We have new life.
我们得着新的生命。
We have the Holy Spirit with us.
我们拥有了圣灵。
Our names are written in the book of life.
我们的名字也被记载在生命册上。
And Jesus invites us to remember him for his work.
而耶稣他也邀请我们纪念他的工作。
So we come to a time of communion.
那么我们来到了领受圣餐的时刻。
I want to invite you to take your cup and the bread.
我要邀请大家拿起你的饼和杯。
And say to ourselves, Lord, forgive me when I have been looking for satisfaction through things, through people, through other ways.
我们可以跟求神原谅，跟神说原谅我。许多时候我都想要从不同的人事物里面找到那份满足。
Help me to know that ultimate contentment can only be found in a real relationship with Jesus Christ.
帮助我们晓得说真正的满足源自于跟神你之间真实活泼的关系。
And before we take of the communion, perhaps we have some needs and concerns in our life. Let's bring it to Jesus right now.
在我们还没有领受圣餐之前，也许我们生命当中有一些的需求，让我们把这一些需求都带到神的跟前。
Because we will receive provision through Christ.
因为我们可以透过基督得到这份供应。
Thank you, Jesus.
感谢耶稣。
Let's take of the bread.
让我们一起领受圣饼。
And drink of the cup.
一起领受圣杯。
There's one song that really spoke to me.
有一首歌真的对我说话。
And the words of the song says, "You are my strength when I am weak."
歌词里面说到，你是我依靠的力量。
You are the treasure that I seek.
你是我寻求的宝藏。
You are my all in all.
你是我的一切。
And then it goes on to say, "Seeking you as a precious jewel."
他说，你好比贵重的珠宝。
Lord, to give up, I'll be a fool.
我怎能放弃你不要？
You are my all in all.
你是我的一切。
This is about Jesus.
这就是耶稣。
And then it says, taking my sin, my cross, my shame.
他说，担当我罪债和羞辱。
Rising again, I bless your name.
死里复活，我蒙救赎。
You are my all in all.
你是我的一切。
When I fall down, you pick me up.
当我跌倒，你扶持我。
When I'm dry, you fill my cup.
当我干渴，你充满我。
You are my all in all.
你是我的一切。
See, Jesus is worthy.
你看，耶稣他配的。
And when we have Jesus, we have everything.
当我们拥有耶稣的时候，我们拥有了一切。
So as we close today,
那今天我们做总结的时候，
I want to invite you to find your satisfaction, your contentment in Christ alone.
我要邀请你在主里面，在耶稣，单单在耶稣里面找到满足、满意。
No matter what you're going through,
不管你在经历些什么，
I pray that you discover
我祷告说你可以发现
the truth of this song,
这首歌的真理，
that Jesus, you are my all in all,
就是耶稣你是我的一切。
And so Father, I thank you for this time.
父神，我们为着这个时刻向你谢恩。
We pray your blessing on everyone right now.
我们祷告神你的祝福倾倒于每一个人。
That we will grow strong in our life because we understand what complete contentment is.
我们的生命将更加的刚强，因为我们真正的认识到什么是完全的满足。
And we pray that we will be able to tell other people about Jesus.
我们祷告说我们的生命可以去诉说，跟别人诉说耶稣你。
And many people who are still trying to find satisfaction through many ways and different things in life.
还有许许多多的人要在寻求生命中的满足，透过不一样的方式。
We pray that we can tell them about Jesus.
我们祷告说，我们可以告诉他们诉说耶稣基督。
The one who truly gives us that satisfaction.
那真正为我们提供终极的。完全的满足的神。
In Jesus' name we pray.
奉耶稣的名我们祷告。
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you for joining us, friends.
朋友们，谢谢你们参与我们。
God bless you.
神祝福你。
See you next week.
我们下个星期再会。
Bye-bye.
再见。
Hello, brothers and sisters.
Hi, 弟兄姐妹。
I want to take this time to specially thank all of you.
我要借此机会跟大家说声谢谢。
For adopting and committing to persevere in gathering together online as a family.
谢谢大家愿意做出调整，委身继续的坚持参加我们的线上崇拜。
It has been more than 40 months that we have not been able to see one another for some of us.
我们当中有一些人已经有将近14个月没有见到彼此了。
As Pastor Dennis has reminded us to find our contentment in Christ.
当 Dennis 牧师提醒我们说我们要在基督里面找到我们真正的满足。
Let us be the church that spurs one another to give thanks, whether in lack or in plenty.
让我们作为教会的，我们可以推动彼此，不管我们在缺乏或者我们有余的时候，我们都可以感恩。
And one of the ways that we can do this is to give thanks for the people around us.
那其中一个方式就是我们为着我们身旁的人向神来谢恩。
You can leave a message of encouragement or appreciation for someone in the comment section down below right now.
你可以在评论区那里留下一些鼓励的言语，珍惜的言语。
Or perhaps WhatsApp someone a message of appreciation today.
甚至于是在今天的时候，你可以发出一些珍惜的信息。
Let's spread the attitude of contentment today.
让我们一起来散播这份满足。
In the kingdom of God, it's more blessed to give than to receive.
在神的国度当中，施比受更为有福。
Giving helps us to focus on our God who is King and our provider.
因为奉献会帮助我们专注于我们的神，就是我们的君王，我们的供应者。
You may give via online bank transfer, Maybank QR Pay or Star Pay.
你可以透过线上转账 Maybank QR Pay 或者 Star Pay 来给予。
Thank you for giving faithfully and cheerfully to the Lord.
感谢你忠心、甘心乐意的给予我们的主。
I believe the word hope means a lot to many of us.
我相信说希望这个字对很多人来言都意义深重。
Not just because it's the name of our church.
当然，它不只是因为它是我们教会的名称。
But it's the very word that gives us something to look forward to.
它也是那一个字为我们带来盼望。
We are living in a fallen world.
我们活在一个堕落的世界。
People and situation may fail us.
人事物都有可能令我们伤心失望。
But God will never fail.
但我们的神不会。
Let's go into this month's Bible reading plan.
让我们来进入我们这个月的圣经阅读计划
，and see the hope that God has set us for us to look forward to。
让我们来探讨神为我们预备的这份盼望。
世上只有妈妈好。I believe many of you know this song。
我相信说有许多的人都知道这首歌。
It is a song sung to appreciate all our mothers。
这首歌的用意是要歌颂母亲。
Don't worry, you won't see me singing for Mother's Day.
放心，你不会看见我为母亲节唱这首歌。
But you see a special presentation for all the mamas out there.
但是我们有一个特别节目提供给我们的所有的母亲。
This is our chance to invite all our friends who are mothers.
这是一个机会，让我们去邀请作为母亲的朋友。
And let them know we appreciate them.
让他们晓得说我们珍惜他们。
That's all for announcement this week.
我们这个星期的报告到此为止。
May the Lord bless you and keep you.
愿耶和华赐福给你，保护你。
May the Lord's face shine on you.
愿耶和华使他的光照亮你。
And be gracious to you.
赐恩给你。
And may the Lord turn his face towards you.
愿耶和华向你扬脸。
And give you peace.
赐你平安。
And see you next week.
我们下周再会。
Thank you.